The basic question we're trying to address with the research is to gain a better understanding of how, when animals diverge in their morphology and development, how that's accomplished at the level of the genes. The main thing that we learned from this research is that a gene that had previously been studied in another insect that was known to be involved in regulating growth and the specialization of cells was also playing a role in changing the size of the wings in these wasps. So we, in effect, what we're doing is using the wing as a tool for measuring genes that are involved in growth. What we found was that there was this gene that has a distant similarity to genes in humans and mice that regulate growth and immunity and cell differentiation. So it's the same gene. That's extremely interesting. And also, what we were able to uncover was how this gene is regulated differently in these closely related species to cause a change in growth. The way that we accomplish this research is using this new emerging insect model called Nasonia. And it's a small insect that has some interesting features in its biology that makes it particularly good for trying to do genetics. One of those is that males only have one set of chromosomes, so that makes it easier for us to detect the effects of any particular gene. So what we were able to do is cross between these very closely related species. We're fortunate in having really young species, so they haven't diverged to the point that they can no longer make hybrids. They're at that early stage of speciation. So we're able to do crosses between them and then grab parts of chromosomes that affect growth, move it into the one or the other species, and then by using basically good old-fashioned recombination, we're able to whittle down the size of the region until we find out what gene it is. We can then break that apart into pieces that allow us to say, well, what parts of surrounding the gene affect when that gene is turned on and when that gene is turned off. The implications of this research are sort of two avenues. One has to do with just increasing our understanding of how growth is regulated in very diverse organisms. And of course, growth is very important in human development, and it's a loss of growth regulation is the hallmark of cancer, for instance. It's also interesting to give us a better understanding of how we get this incredible diversity of life that we see around us. Animals and plants diverge from each other in their shape and their form. It's one of the marvels of nature, but we still don't have a very good understanding of how that's accomplished.